The first Indianapolis 500 race began the transformation of the contest into a mythic spectacle of international dimensions. The 1912 race completed the process by providing a double purse and a sympathetic hero. The greatest drama happened at the end of the race. On the third lap, Ralph DePalma put his big Mercedes in the lead. On lap 196, only four laps from the end, his engine threw a connecting rod. DePalma had a big lead and tried to nurse his car to the finish line on three cylinders and no oil. But just over one lap from the end, the engine finally froze. DePalma and his riding mechanic, Rupert Jeffkins, jumped out and began pushing the heavy car to the pits. As they came by the grandstand, thousands stood and cheered with a roar that practically drowned out the race cars. A game, brave competitor was giving it his best right to the end. It was Shakespeare and Greek tragedy and Don Quixote, all wrapped up in the grease-smeared person of Ralph DePalma. But cheers didn't win the race. Second-place runner Joe Dawson streaked by them and took the checkered flag. DePalma came in 11th. After Dawson crossed the finish line, Ralph Mulford was running last among the surviving cars. He knew he'd get no money unless he finished all 200 laps, so he was willing to persevere through mechanical problems, taking a record 8 hours and 53 minutes to finish 10th at an average speed of 56.29. Ralph DePalma went on to win the race in 1915, but he was always remembered best for that 1912 finish. Years later, World War II correspondent and Hoosier Ernie Pyle said, "I would rather be Ralph DePalma than president. I would rather win that race than anything in the world." The 1912 race was a resounding success. New York papers were already calling it the largest sporting event in America. In 1913, the rules were changed to attract entries from Europe. It worked. 8 of the 27 cars in this race were from Europe. There were new grandstands for this race and a new Japanese-style scoring pagoda. Standing tall in the infield of the flat Indiana land, the exotic pagoda seemed to emphasize the worldwide dimensions of the contest.